crying for a long time. I've been crying for a long time. And these tears are becoming way in my mind, tossing me up against the rock, slamming me up against the banks with the sand. The same. Oh, I cry, and I don't want to cry anymore. And I have prayed on my knees. And I know he's here with me, but I still cry. Oh, I cry all the time.
Usually things dear to your heart, isn't it? Something that's real sad, that really means something, that is hard to part from. What about the things that you lose and you never knew you were losing them? And as time went on, you realized that they're not coming back. It's not coming back. That part right there. I need to pray for that part right there. To give it to God. That broken heart part. That's what I want to do for myself. I guess now is a better time than ever. The last couple of videos I put up, boy, if I will, that's where it stops. I don't know the future. All I know is the past. And the past haunts me and hurts me. All come together. Seems like it's just been one big circle that's united. You know, will the circle be unbroken? I believe I know now what that means. That's something. That's something. You know, when I started all of this, you know, the Holy Spirit is like a dove that come down and land on Jesus when they come back. There, and on the Baptist. God said, I'm well pleased. You know, a lot of people say, I'm proud. But our Heavenly Father said, I'm well pleased. I mean, that's kind of a problem, but how we worded it, not so more. Words can hurt some. He said, it can be understood. Can work, you know. Well, I know I am. And the other thing gave me the change for me. But the biggest decision I have is simply for myself. I'm not. I'm going to put myself in treatment. Counselor in the church. I've been here before, you know. And I can see that it's gotten on me. I know. Yeah. It's got control of me. That makes his decisions when I thought I was just turning against him or stuff. So I guess, you know, when I never knew what this future is now. So I'm going to face the battle. Shut down for a while. Dry out. You know, my daddy was an alcoholic. My grandpa was an alcoholic. They brought their own family, you know. I worked my mom. And thank God I knew what to make about it, because that's very important. I know that I can't do this by myself. I recognize that. And I, hope to make some changes that are better for me instead of suffocating. You know? I love you. Thank you. Get hold of yourself. When I started this journey with the Lord on March 23rd, 2020, You took all of this away. I had none of this. The first my starting point was this music of the Lord. Because he asked me. Some people don't want to believe that, but I don't care. Because I even said to him, I don't have a voice. You know what I'm saying? I was always telling him, he was wanting me to do things. And I was arguing back. If I look back on it now, why I couldn't. But he was still putting all this knowledge in me with the Holy Spirit. I know what happened to me. I was with God. And I screwed it all up. And he had to leave. And when he left, he said, you can't fool me twice. And it was sin. There's no excuse for it. That's how I feel at this point. Even a personal. Because I believe it hurts to evolve with him. And I just believe him. But I believe man. And, you know, getting closer and seeing some scriptures has helped me get knowledge of my Heavenly Father. And I've grown, but I'm also very mature. And I love my personal relationship with God. And I wasn't supposed to do that. And now I can look back and see that that when he came into my life that night, I had none of it. I didn't desire to do drugs. I didn't desire to even smoke. My eyes, I didn't even need my glasses. He even said that I would put back my glasses, and he said, you don't need your glasses. My eyes will hurt. Look. The best way I can say this is that I didn't listen to God. And by not listening to him, I did my own thing. And I'm pretty disgusted with myself. Because I didn't put God first in any of this instead I changed him this morning. Because I'm changed. I'm different. I look at the bedroom as completely different than what he had. And it wasn't foolish of me to think or believe that he could believe Jesus like I do, and Jehovah God, the Father, Jesus Christ. Died for us, amen, walked around and talked about us, Father. I believe that's the way of God. Holy Scriptures are spiritually fed to the people that know it. It's divine. I believe that. I was really close to God for about 3 months. And that's about where I want to stop, because that's where I started to get it. And it wasn't right, what I've done. So, I think I've messed it all up. I completely messed it all up. It wasn't what God wanted. At this point, I don't want to say the devil has won by no account. But have I gotten a blow? Yeah, not really something about myself. Thank God I don't make mistakes, but I do. And he has patience. He understands. And in these moments right here of getting smacked with truth, knowledge, and understanding, and even about myself, because nothing's going to change until I get there. Nothing. And I'm so sorry, y'all. I'm so sorry. It's actually horrible what I've done. But listen, I believe God has a purpose for my life more than I ever believe ever before. I believe he's calling me out for a reason that I yet don't understand. But as long as I continue to do God's will for my life, do what God says, what the Bible says. Try to be like Jesus. Some guessing things. What was supposed to be? What was supposed to be like his son? And that means something, especially after what I've experienced. I wasn't right, but I'm very thankful for the Lord. Because he has lightened my burdens. He has lifted the load. Even with what I'm going through now. Because of my past experience, if it hadn't been for God, I know I would not be here telling you this, or talking to you about this, or even have some means. I never saw one if I didn't have. I want to get clean.